Uniqueness of God is something very important, because if there is many gods, okay, there is many choices. You can go to the first one, or you go to the second one, and sometimes you'll be confused which one that you want to go to, okay? This is a problem, okay? So God, it have to be one. And in any kind of partnership, that sometimes, somehow, is going to be some kind of disagreement, or somebody, some one of the two or the three has more power than the other. And the other partner will try to get rid of this power. Okay. So it is very important by nature, okay, and also by the teaching of the prophets, that we get to know and to believe that God Almighty is one, and his oneness is unique. So he is one and the only one. And this is what makes it necessary to devote ourselves to him, to obey him, to honor him, and not to bring anybody, you understand, to be in a form of a partner or mediator. Okay. You see? Why? Because he is the one. So if you want to love, if you want to fear, if you want to devote, will be one. This make it much easier on the people to worship. Much simple to understand, okay? But when you have more than one, now you have to divide your time. Mm-hmm. You have to divide your emotion. You have to, so this is all this is going to cause you a problem, and later on, you may even get tired.
Yeah.
Should I?
Go to this one or this one.
Exactly. Yeah. Should I go to God the Father, or God the Son, or God the Holy Ghost? Which one? Yeah. Okay? And which one have more power? And which one can give me this first? Mm-hmm. But when you know that there is one, and this the one, and the only one, that you understand that I can obey, so I'm not going to have a competition. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to have a confusion.
That makes sense.
And this we call it monotheism, oneness of God. To make things much easier in you, that you know that your God Almighty is one and alone and unique. He is good in everything, perfect in everything, the one in everything. So if we want to talk about knowledge, he has possessed all the knowledge. If you talk about wisdom, he the most wise one. If you're talking about strength and power, he's the most stronger one. So there, that means you bring individual or a collective body is not going to be equal to God. Mm-hmm. Like you say, 2 + 2 + 1 equal?
5.
And 3 + 2 equal? 5. And 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 equal 5. You see? So here we're talking about uniqueness. So it doesn't matter, you bring a country or small group of people or me and my wife or my wife and my partner at work. Doesn't matter, you bring little people or many people, doesn't matter how big, it still could not be equal to God in anything. Okay, in anything. So knowledge, he possesses all the knowledge. And he say, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. You are not being given anything from knowledge. Okay? This is something very important that we have to understand. Is okay. Okay? That you are not being given from knowledge except a little. Therefore, and maybe you understand, know your name. I can speak your language. But I'm not going to know his name and his language. And if I know his name, I'm not going to speak his language. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, you could not. You have a limitation because you are being created and you're a human being. Mm-hmm. You have limitation in your vision. Is this true?
Yes, sir.
You can see from here to the wall. But can you tell me what's behind the wall? No, not because you're blind. Neither that there is nothing behind the wall, but because we are limited. There is something comes, you understand, to become a partition or a obstacle in your way you could not see. Mm-hmm. Same thing we hear. But somebody 10 miles from here Okay, when you call your name, you're not going to hear him. Okay? God Almighty doesn't need all this. He can see with no limitation. He can hear with no limitation. He can understand with no limitation. So we limit it. All right? So when a president of a country go to another country, he now need to get somebody to translate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But if you go to China, he needs a Chinese one who knows Chinese and English. If you go to French, it's not going to be the same one.
Yeah.
Okay? It's going to be somebody who knows English and French to translate.
Yes, sir.
This limitation with a human being, as individual, as collective. So when we talk about power, nothing can be equal to God. Like I said, two and three, three and one, still five.
Yeah.
So there is nothing can be equal to God in his power,
okay,
in his knowledge,
okay,
in his wisdom, in his mercy, in his patience. Inequality, we have some of it, mm-hmm, as individual or collectively. You can sit and listen to me for half an hour, but after 2 hours they say, oh, I have to go to the bathroom. Oh, my mother is calling me. Oh, you see, or can I take a nap and after this I come to the second session? We have limitation.
Mm-hmm.
God doesn't have limitation.
Okay.
You see, this is the reason he became God, okay, or the God and the only God. Anything else is a false God and false deity. Not because there is false gods, but the people made up gods.
Mm-hmm.
Some people see the lion to be a stronger animal in the forest. Some people see the fire can do this and that. Some people see the sun when it shine, cover everything.
Mm-hmm.
So people made up gods. But there is no gods. There is only one God.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this is established in your understanding, so I don't want to drill on it too much. But although you say that he is one, you have to understand that he's one in his person and one in his quality. Nobody can match him, not as individual, not as a collective. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
So if we bring China and America and Russia and all so-called superpower, their knowledge or their mighty is not going to be equal to God by any way. If I turn to God, so I'm turning to the most knowledgeable one, the most powerful one, the most capable one.
Mm-hmm.
Your best friend, for some reason, one day he can turn his back to you. Your job, doesn't matter who you are, for some reason. Maybe you became 65 years old, 70 years old. So, oh, Mr. Well, Chris is
yes.
We appreciate what he did. You can stay home. You understand? We're going to be paying you, understand, 80% of yourself, but we could not use your service anymore because you can see now. Okay, is that you could not?
My bad back.
You see, this is reality. Okay, but with God Almighty, it's totally different. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
This what, so we have to understand what does it mean when we say one, that he is one. So people can turn their back in you, your best friend, your best boyfriend, girlfriend, wife, mother, for some reason, or they die. They don't have to turn their back, but they die. This is our nature. God Almighty doesn't die. Okay? As long as you give yourself to him and put him as a priority, now you have to count an endless assistance, protection, everything. So if you have God with you,
mm-hmm,
you got everything, even if you have nothing. Can you understand this?
Yes, sir.
And if you have everything, that means from the material thing, but Almighty God is not with you, you got nothing. Because, oh, I have money, but
when you leave, you won't.
Okay. Oh, what about got sick? I could not even use the money. I can go to the best hospital, best doctor, but they could not deal with my problem. So it's still money. So everything can turn its back to you. But when you choose to submit yourself to God Almighty, the only true and the only God, God will be there for you at any time. And maybe in certain time, okay, that if he thinks is not working, but this is a test for you. This is a way to strengthen you, to teach you. Is not that he turned his back to you, but for a knowledge that we could not comprehend it, he's training you, get you through certain stages to grow, to be stronger. You understand?
Yes.
But when you almost say that this is a, what you call it, the straw that breaks the camel back, when you almost in the last thin hair that is going to cut, you find the victory come. The assistant is coming. The doors is open. But you go through certain training. Same thing that when you went to the army base. Before, you understand, people feeding you and clean your clothes. And after this, they turn and they start. And 4 o'clock, you're waking up, marching, jumping. And after this, you became part of you. So you went through some hardship until you got to certain, you understand, level of capability to do certain things. Okay? But people can do different exercise and training and things like that. But the personality, it need more discipline. The soul, the heart needs the purification, needs the cleanliness, need to understand that you really trust God and God alone. Okay? That you really to love him and his love to be the greater love. Because he is one. And he's the only one deserve everything. God is the creator. So he created us. And this is a blessing. God is the giver of gifts. Okay? We have vision. We have eyes. We have hearing. We have ability to communicate, to express ourselves. So, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Whatever favor that you have is from Almighty God. You have to always remember this. So that means you have to be grateful to him, thankful to him, okay, to submit to him, to obey him to the best of your ability. Remember now that God Almighty, because he is the one who created you, he knows about every inch in you. Therefore, he never ever command you or any nations before us to do something beyond their capability or ability. You believe in this? Because he's the creator. Who will know about the creation more than the creator? Same thing like understand you fixing aircraft, okay? Who will be the person you think the captain? He's a captain, he fly an aeroplane. But when something wrong with the aeroplane, you see? It's different. They will call in who?
Call me.
You, okay? Why? Although you could not fly, because you've been trained in a special thing, okay? God Almighty is not been trained. He is the one who created everything, so he is familiar with everything. What is good for your body, what good for your soul, what good for your mind. Therefore, that God Almighty always gave us Emmanuel. Emmanuel, okay? That catalog to know how to erect or fix or make things to be upright and to be in the right way. If you use the hammer for to be a ruler, it's not going to work. Okay? And if you use the ruler to be to hammer a nail with it, you may break it. You see? So God Almighty, he created us. He knows about our mind, our thoughts, our desires, our weakness, okay? So he did not legislate something beyond your capability. Neither he required from you that you do something beyond what he can. But we sometimes so spoiled. We don't want to do it. We're dragging our feet. But when comes push to show or whatever, still some strength been hidden here and there, but you don't want to answer. Maybe somebody else will come, give me a hand. But you could not find any assistance. Say, okay, I'm going to find a way. I'm going to lift this motor and put it because the fly have to go. Okay? I called sons, I called sons, sons, you understand? Nobody available to come. Now we're going to get a 2x4 or anything, and you're going to make somehow so you can be able, now I'm close to the airplane, now I'm going to lift it and push it and put it and put the screws and goes. So we have to be sincere about what we're doing. That means we really need to devote ourselves as much as we can to what we believe in it, so it will work. But if I'm going to take it like a part-time, or when I think, in the weekend, then it's not going to work. Yes, we understand that baby have to crawl first. No problem. And after this, he will walk. No problem. But will be coming time, we are not going to allow this child to crawl. Okay, was used to be, but no more. So we understand when people come to Islam, they're going to be babies, they're going to learn, but will come time that no crown will be accepted. You're going to have to walk. And in certain time, maybe you could not walk, you're going to have to run. Because if you did not run, you are not catching your flight. And it say time to run, so you have to run. And we do this with a human being. What about the one? And human gives us what? Gives us a job, gives us money. But all your money, all the money you get is not equal to one gift of God, the eye, as example. Is this true? Is this reality? You see? So God gave us a lot. And we need to open our eyes really to see the gifts of God. Do you know how many people... They could not sit down like you're sitting like this and you can breathe in your air without even doing anything. You're not running machine with your hand to breathe, is it? Are you? You're sitting, talking to me and listening and you're still breathing. It's nothing. You even go sleep and close your eyes almost like that and you're still breathing. All this is gifts and blessings. So really, if we can see the gifts and open our eyes that God has given us, we will try to devote ourselves sincerely as much as we can to him. He doesn't need us, but we need him. This is something that you need to know. Okay? That he doesn't need us. Because before he created you or me, he is God. And he was God, and he will still to be God. And when I die, you die, everybody will die, he still will be God. Because God Almighty doesn't die. You see? So when somebody understands saying that Jesus is God or Son of God, and you know for fact that he has to die, okay, at least for us to be forgiven, so that God, in a certain time, he was dead, according to what they teach. If he's God, how he can die? Oh, but he was the Son of God. Yeah, he's the Son of God. So if he's the Son of God, he's supposed to get the nature of God, of his Father. You see? So all this fabrication and all these things put together, if you really think about it, it doesn't make any sense. How God can die? Because if 10, 15 Jews get together and crucified the Son of God, so... Nowadays, we don't need, you understand, 10, 15. We have aeroplane, we have tanks and all these things. We can, you understand, fire tanks against God and we can kill God. So this is it. Because it's supposed to be some Jews got together and crucified Jesus. It can 5, 10, 15, even 100. So today we don't have 100. We have thousands, we have millions, we have billions. So why we don't get together also and kill Father the God? So God could not die. Neither can get killed. You see? So God Almighty, before we born, he was God. After we born, he is God. After we die, because we're going to die. At least I'm going to die, is it? All of us, is it? So all of us are going to die. Doesn't matter who you are, you like it or not, you're going to die. Is this reality? But he will still to be God. And he's going to be the one inherit everything. And he will resurrect us after our death. And he will judge us about what we did in this life. So we are here passing through. It's only like a journey. Okay? And when the train stops, Zero stop, you're going to get out. Next stop will be mine. Next stop will be his. Like this, until the train goes to the end, and they said, nobody in the train. The train is finished. The journey is finished. Mm-hmm. Now, you're going to recharge, refuel, whatever it is, maintenance, okay? So God Almighty made life for people to interact and to deal with each other. And he's watching them. And he told them that he's watching them about what they're doing. Mm-hmm. How you talk, how you act, how you behave. And he told us that everything is going to be recorded. Before they have the camera, they have the TV, they have the spine aeroplanes, all these things. God can see everybody in the same time, understand all the language in every time. But this is the reason he became God. Nobody can match the ability of God. So he told us that this is a transition, that you're going to go from A to B, and from B is going to be resurrected, and you're going to be gathered again. And there in B or C, you're going to be judged. And after this, you're going to go to your final station, which is going to be a punishment or going to be a favor and a blessing and enjoyment. So we need to make the choice here with two things. You lay down a foundation and you erect a building. Okay? This is the two things. Your foundation is the belief. And your building is the good deed. You could not take one. You go spend all your money in laying down the foundation. So now when it rains, I'm getting wet because I didn't make a building. Yes, I did a good foundation. But I have no roof. I have no windows. So when it's raining, I'm getting wet. Mm-hmm. You see? Now, I didn't put the foundation and I built a house. Now, a little bit water comes from the ocean because no foundation. Mm-hmm. So you have two things. One is the foundation, and one is the building. Now you can secure something for yourself. The foundation is the belief. And the building is the conduct, the behavior. So we could not take one and leave the other. And both of them are important, very important. I have to believe, and I have to do a good deed. The belief, number one, and the most, and the foremost of all things, is what? Believing in oneness of Almighty God, attributes of Almighty God. You could not mess up with this, with anything. Mm-hmm. Any little hair misunderstanding in it is terrible. There is a blueprint. Now, me and you are not qualified to put the blueprint. Therefore, Almighty the Creator, He made the blueprint. He said, you want to have the good life in the hereafter, you want to go to heaven, you want. This is the blueprint. And He sends the blueprint with the messenger to teach us and to show it and to explain it to us. You got it, me? You understand? Yes, sir. You sure you follow me?
I follow you.
You getting tired or you want to...
I follow you.
Okay. So... because God Almighty is merciful. Mm-hmm. He can put us in the earth and say, found your way. You see?
And get lost.
And most of us will be lost if it's not all of us.
Yeah.
But out of his kindness, gentleness, merciful concern, he sent a blueprint. And with the blueprint, Mr. Engineer, to explain it to you. Do it like this. Go this way, here stop, here you don't stop, here go straight. Okay. So this is simple. If you follow, you'll be successful and you pass the test. If not, say, oh, this looks nice here. Oh, this is, oh, this. And you get distracted by different things. Money, job, wife, children, car, this, that. And after this, after he was young now, 15 years later, 10 years later, now, cane, okay, or kidney problem, or whatever it is, I'm not the same person. And the next thing, rush him to the hospital, rush him. So there is many things attractive us. But if we did not keep in mind from the beginning, day one, that we can, with these things, yes, he can eat. Yes, he can get married. Okay? But you've been created originally, number one, to get to know your Creator and to obey Him. This is the priority. So everything else comes to patch or to assist this main purpose that you are here. You are not here to eat because the horse eats, the dog eats, the cat eats, everything eats. You are not here to work. This is number one priority because the horse pulls the cart. He's doing a job. Okay? And the dog doing a job. At least he parking when somebody coming to attack or to come to steal from the house. So everything done. So we and animals are not the same. God Almighty make us unique and better by giving us understanding, give us mind to think, to reflect, you see, that we can communicate, all right? So we are the best creature or creation of Almighty God, okay? And we own the other things. The horse doesn't owe you. You don't go, the horse doesn't buy you. You buy the horse, you buy the dog, you train the dog, you put the dog where you want. The dog doesn't tell you, understand, oh, I want to be in the living room. I don't want to be outside of the house. It doesn't do, you see? So we are here to do what God wants us to do. And He knows better than us, and He intends good for us. So He created us, put us in the earth, and He sent the blueprint, and He select a qualified person from the human being and reveal to him. Go to the people and tell them, this is what pleases me and this displeases me. This is wrong, this is right. And they explain it to them. And tell them there is a reward and there is a punishment. Those who listen and obey, they're going to be given such and such. Not now, when you finish the exam. Okay? Mm-hmm. And those who disobey me, they will get this and that. But not now. Okay? You here, you choose. You have a choice. But when you die, when you come to meet me, will be the final. And there's no another chance. Mm-hmm. You see? So now, what is this holy story is about? God Almighty sent something called blueprint. This is what we call the book, the revelation, the gospel, the New Testament, the Old Testament, the previous books, the final book or the final testament, the Quran. This is what you call the blueprint. That means whatever you do, it has to be according to the guidance. Okay, this is the blueprint. The messenger came with it to explain, because something simple for you to understand by yourself and somebody to be explained and demonstrated in action. This is what we call a messenger. Mm-hmm. But the messenger is still a human being like me and you. He can get sick, he can die, he can get hurt, okay? But he's most qualified to teach and to go and give the people good example. Like the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon the last prophet. Like the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon the Prophet Moses, Abraham, all those prophets. You see? So this is the way how God Almighty Allah, we say Allah. Some people say Jehovah. Some people say God. What this is not the name, is the issue now. Is who is the God and the only God? The Creator, the Giver, the Provider, the Withholder, the one who gives life, the one who causes death. You understand? This is what it is. Okay. Mother Nature, what is Mother Nature? Say, and you know, the 510 news, you understand, the Mother Nature and the disaster was the Mother Nature. Was the Mother Nature? No. Mother Nature is what? Is a flood? Is trees? Is what is Mother Nature? You understand? The Mother Nature, we ourselves, we can stop the Mother Nature. Okay? We build something in advance. Okay, that when there is a flood, when an earthquake, we're given a lot, you understand? So we fighting, and sometimes we take over the mother nature. It's hot here, I turn the air condition on, you see? So we have ability over the mother nature. So we stronger than God? What's this? A mountain, you go, this is a mother nature. You make a hole, you make a tunnel, and now you can go cars back and forth. So people understand the... They try to make something different from the real God. There is only one God. Mm-hmm. Okay? And if it's going to be something physical in front of you, you can see it, everybody will be a believer. When did you slow down in your speed on the highway?
When the stop sign told me to.
No, there is no stop sign on the highway.
Oh, well.
When limit. Did you slow down in the highway? When
you see a cop.
When you see the blue light behind you, you or you see that, you understand, crossing the... Why? So that means if God will be visible to you like this, everybody will turn to be a believer. Okay? Nobody going to break the law, because be scared, be afraid, okay, apprehend it, you understand? Okay, but God Almighty choose to be unseen in this life. So really, so when you do it in a base of belief. But he shows that he exists by telling you about certain things. You examine it, you find this is true. As example, God Almighty saying in his book, وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. And we created you in pairs. You found this, exactly, okay? 99.999, okay, that everything, human being or anything, male and female. So he gives you in the book certain things to back up the statement that he is the only God, and you go to examine it, you found it exactly. Okay? Mm-hmm. But he himself is still unseen to us in this life. You see? Why? Because... when the students, when they see the teacher come in the class, everybody's acting as if they were doing the homework, and you see. But as long as the teacher talking with the other teacher in the hallway outside, everybody throwing joy, understand, doing this. And so this is nature of a human being. And this, you understand, we do it. We see the blue light, you put your foot in the brake, understand, and you start, you understand, yeah.
You're the best driver in the world.
You see? Yeah. So this is part of our shortcoming of nature of a human being. So God Almighty made miracles in the book to show you that he is God and he's the only one worthy of being obeyed. And he will send a messenger with the book. He will explain the book. And after this, the messenger, you understand, is a human being. He will die. God Almighty will send another messenger. People will forget, and the messenger die, and nation after nation. So God Almighty will send another messenger out of his mercy. Now, human being, you understand, now graduated from elementary to middle school to high school to college. That now they became, you understand, master degree, PhD degree. So now God Almighty had given them the final message. Because now they can understand, they can comprehend, they understand. So all the revelations that came before, we believe in it, that from God. It has a source, is from God, is not man-made. But later on, that God Almighty had a choose that this is the time that a human being now ready to take the final messenger and the final message, and the final book, and this will be the law for them until the day of resurrection. How we can know this is true? What this man talking about? If you examine the existing books, basically we have two or three books. There's a competition happening between them. Okay, people making religions. Okay, many, many religions there. But the things that has a code and a book, basically, is mostly three: Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Mm-hmm. Okay? This is basically. Yeah. There is other people, Hindus and Buddhism, and but as a revealed book that is still in existence, okay? Some people claiming, but what basically now on the stage, there are three, okay? Communities, books, revelation, whatever. If you bring any of the three books could not deal with the reality of today other than the Quran. When you read the Bible, basically most of it about stories and about, you understand, proper behavior about your neighbors and somebody slap you on this side, give him this other side, and this is it. But it's not talking about any transaction, business, marriage, problems, solution, politics, social life. You could not. The only book that deals with everything is the Quran, which is the last revelation. Okay? You could not be in a college and say, no, I'm going to count. Give me what you call this marble. What is this? They call it marble?
Marbles,
yeah. Yeah. I'm going to count one, and one, and one is two, and two, and two, and add one. No. You graduated. You can use timetable. You can use algebra. I am not going to allow you to go there because this when you was in elementary. Now you are advanced. Okay. Yes, this system is correct, but not for you. Yes. This was when you was 6 years old, 10 years old. Okay. So the validity of this is not working, but it's still correct in some senses. Oh, but now you a master degree. Now you are a PhD degree now. Now you're ready to carry a job and teach the people. You see? Yeah. So we give the final now. So God Almighty Allah, we say Allah, okay? Or if you want to say God for now, or the God, or the Creator, okay? Almighty the Creator had given the final and the last final book with the blueprint, with the messenger. The messenger died already, but the blueprint, it didn't change. And it is a challenge. And this itself to show, to prove that it is from God. Okay? Jesus. Do you know Jesus? Did you hear about Jesus? Did you hear this name before?
I have. He was Christian. He's a son of God.
Like, okay.
And then this religion is prophet. He's
a prophet. Okay. Yes. What kind of miracles did Jesus, give me one of the miracles that Jesus performed.
In Christianity?
Yeah.
He made that bread feed everybody, I guess.
Okay. Yeah. Did he see this?
No.
You didn't. Tell me about Moses. Do you know Moses?
Part of the Red Sea.
Okay. With what?
His hands.
With his hand? Okay. Can you show me this today?
No.
Can you bring Moses' hand today?
No.
Can you bring the bread of Jesus today? But people had believed by seeing, and they saw the sea, they saw the bread, they believed. What about me today? I could not see anything.
No.
Okay? So now if I say I have excuse not to believe, I may have a valid excuse. But when the last messenger came and the last book came, he left something that you can bring it to anybody at any time, any place. What it is a book. It's a symbol. A book. Okay? 10 years ago, or 100 years ago, or 1,000 years ago, was the same thing. The same miracle was a book. Now we don't... You could not ask me, bring Muhammad here. I said, Muhammad is a human being. He died. But can you bring his hand here? No, I said he did not use his hand. He gave us a book, came from God. The book is a change. It stands for a challenge to any book, to any scholar, individual or collectively. In that book, as example, say one thing, and I'm going to give it to you now. If you or anybody, the church, the government, anybody, say this. Well, we have many books. This book came with, I'm only giving you example. يا أيها الناس ضرب مثل فاستمعوا له إن الذين تدعون من دون الله لن يخلقوا ذبابا ولو اجتمعوا له. This in Surah called Pilgrimage, Surah Al-Hajj in the Quran, I will show to you. Say, O mankind, he did not say, O Muslims, he say, O mankind, there is a parable been brought forward for you. Those you call them or invoke them or look up to them to be gods other than Almighty Allah the Creator, they could not create a fly. They could not create a fly. Even if they combine their efforts, their knowledge, their ability, their machines, their computers, their technology, they are not going to be able to create a fly. Even if they combine their effort together. And more than this, if the fly take away something from them, they could not get it back. Think about this. Did you ever see United States making an aeroplane?
See it, but...
Did you? No, okay. Do you know there is a manufacturing and the people get together and put an aeroplane. Is this true or not?
Yes.
And how big is the aeroplane?
Depends on what type it is, I
okay,
guess.
Okay, so big.
Yeah.
God did not talk about aeroplane. He talked about something. Let me give you something small, okay? Since you think you understand, you're so tough. Okay, what about you make this small thing? He did not say aeroplane. How many people, you understand? 300, 500, 1,000 people. How many kilos, pounds go? All these things, okay?
Can you care about?
But Russia is a superpower, is it?
Yes.
America's superpower. China, look how China now is covering the market in everything, okay? Economics, all these things, okay? Why nobody stand up to defeat the Quran and say, you guys, your book say something wrong, and I'm going to show you that Jesus is God, or the Mother Nature is God. I'm going to defeat your challenge, and I'm going to create a fly. You try to tell me that nobody ever saw this in the Quran? Okay, why they did not create a fly and tell the fly, fly? You know they do all these things for kids to play with, what you call these dolls and things like this. And even they have ships inside. Hey, mommy, mommy. And you understand, you make noise and talks. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, they do all these things. No, we don't want to understand dog or a doll or anything like this. Now, can you make, and they can even shape something like a fly. But make a fly and let us see. Make a fly. Do like, huh? And the fly. Make a fly. Create a fly. Okay? And let it fly in front of us. If you do this, you challenge one single verse in the book, you cancel something called Islam and Muslim. You have no foundation to stand on it.
Yeah.
Do it. And not do it for you or him. All of us. No, not all of us. All America. No, no, not all America. America and Russia and China and everybody. They could not. Maybe you would think about it, but it's in the book. I give you one thing more so I don't understand, bore you with the conversation. The book is one book. Doesn't matter. In the book, God Almighty saying, the Creator saying, I reveal the book. I send it down. And it is upon me, that means Almighty the Creator, to protect it, preserve it. It's not going to change. It's not going to be two Quran. It's not going to be three Quran. It's not going to be two different chapter, and you got the other Quran according King James will be a different chapter. And after this, you go to the Mormon, you will find a different chapter. And you find after this Jehovah's Witness, they said to you, their Bible is wrong and our Bible is right. God said one verse. You take, this is a miracle, life miracles that you can put your hands on it. because you could not bring the stick of Moses, you could not bring the hand of Jesus, but you can bring a book that came with the Prophet Muhammad. Muhammad did not make it, okay? But it is to be until the day of judgment. Anybody say, I want to see it. I want my soul to be in ease that this is the true thing. I said, here. This book used to be printed in Arabia before because people know Arabic and things like this. Mm-hmm. Today, with the modern technology, get any book in any language. You have this offset and printers and all these things that you can take a good, nice shot and they can copy thousands and thousands. Doesn't matter what is the language. Mm-hmm. Nobody, and I say it and I mean it, and I challenge anybody, nobody can bring two different Quran. Even if somebody play games and they try to do it, it defeated like this in a matter of a day or two. It will found the news everywhere, you see? So you bring a Quran, print it in China. And you bring another Quran. When I say Quran, means the Arabic, not the English translation. English translation is something to facilitate for somebody who understands that is not Arabic-speaking person, okay, to know what is the Quran is about. But basically, you will find translations so close. Maybe one say gate, one say door, one say exit. It's still close, okay? It depends how. But we're talking about the Arabic Quran. Now, sitting here, I can get up and get you 10 different Qurans. One printed in Egypt, one printed in Lahore, one printed in India, one printed in German, and we're going to open chapter 20. Mm-hmm. Verse, any verse, you choose a verse. Number what?
312.
Number 312, okay? 312, anything, okay? And I'm going to tell you, read the second word. You read the second word. You read the second word from the same place. It's going to be exactly waljibala. It's going to be the same word.
Okay.
There is no single country, for your knowledge, stand behind the Quran to make sure nobody play games with it or add or delete. It is God's work. He promised in the book, and we can see his promise is fulfilled. You see?
It was all over the news a few days ago, too, that they have found an 1,800-year-old printed Quran.
Yes.
And they have measured it with a newly printed Quran, and it was word by word the same.
It's not word by word. Vowel, letters.
Every single thing.
You'd be surprised, okay? Yeah. For your knowledge, I want to tell you one thing. Do you know that it common among the Muslims, Arab and non-Arab, to memorize the whole Quran from cover to cover? You could not bring one person among the Christian community that memorize the Bible. Not read the Bible, memorize. Now we're talking about this book. You see how big it is? We have kids 11, 15, 20 years old. They know it from cover to cover. Not one or 100. We're talking about thousands. Okay? Mm-hmm. You did not have one Christian that memorized the whole Bible. And I'm making this as a challenge. And I know what I'm talking about. Do you know why?
Because it's so different in each Bible.
Exactly. This is one thing. They could not. They could not even agree about which Bible is the Bible of. That the one that Jesus had, because this is supposed to be the word of Jesus, coming from God. You have the red additional Bible. Did they ever heard about it? I have a copy of it, okay, in my office. That means some of the writing is in red, and some is written, the color of the ink is black. When you ask somebody who knows about Bibles, mm-hmm. and ask him, why is two colors? He will say, this is the word of Jesus, and this is the words of the prophets after him. So actually, the whole Bible is not the word of Jesus. You see?
Yeah.
So we are not denying the previous book. We believe that Jesus had received the Injil, what you call the New Testament. We believe that Moses had received from God Almighty the Old Testament, which we call the Torah. We believe in it. But after the death, you understand, of Moses and the lifting up of Jesus, peace be upon him, people corrupted and adding and changing and things like this. So how you can trust something that you don't know the history of it, and you did not see, you understand, that matching and all these things. But you could not find this in there. So part of the belief, believing in all the messengers for you to be a Muslim. Part of the belief, to believe in all the prophets. Part of the belief for you to be a believer, to make your foundation. You remember?
Mm-hmm.
About a few days ago, we talked about foundation and building. You remember?
Yes.
When we talk about
yeah,
it, eh? Yes. Foundation is the belief.
Yeah.
We talk to believe in oneness of God. You have to believe in all the messengers. So you have to believe in Jesus, in Moses, in Joseph, in Jacob, in Abraham, Ishmael. You have to believe in all the books that have been revealed before. You have to believe in the angels. You have to believe in the day of judgment and resurrection. You have to believe in predestination. All these things part of your foundation. And if you master your foundation and inspection done, everything is go according to the blueprint, now you can start little bit by little bit. You build a wall today, tomorrow you make another wall, next week, understand, next month will be another wall. After this, you put the windows, and after this, doors, you put a carpet, now electrician comes, and one day you find yourself, you understand, have foundation and a building, and you enjoy in your house. This is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
So this basically, for you, I'm sorry, forget, I keep forgetting your name, Chris?
Jason.
Oh, Jason, okay.
It's close
yes.
to Chris.
Eh?
Close to Chris.
Okay. No. This is not fair. You understand? Jason. Okay. Okay. So you see, Jason, now what I'm talking about? Now you have a little bit, because you see, when you give me the mic, it's not easy to take it from me. Okay. I can go for hours and hours, but
I'm
I have
listening.
I understand. You're a good listener. But basically, this is, in a nutshell, this is what they call it. And if you think and say it's something that you're interested in it, you're more than welcome. Islam is not belong to me or to him, to anybody. Islam is for only one. And this is the only boat. Did you hear about a prophet by name Noah? Noah?
Like Noah's Ark?
Yes.
Yeah.
The people who got in the ship, those people who had been delivered, been saved. Those people, even his son, he said, no, I'm going to go on the top of the mountain. Okay, but God, when he sends a flood, cover everything. No one been saved except the prophet Noah and those who in the ship. So any ideology nowadays is not acceptable with God. It used to be a methodology in a certain time. Today is not. It's elementary or middle school. Today you are in college for your master and PhD degree, you won't take it. This is the only thing who can qualify you or disqualify you.
Yeah.
So this, I'm giving it to you in a nutshell. I can give you more books. You understand? You took the green one. I can give you a brown one today. You can take a look, think, ask questions. And if you think this is something fits you and this is something that you be part of it, we'll be glad to welcome you and tell you how to be a Muslim. You want to think about it more, sleep more, net more, and ask a question more. It's up to you. It's no compulsion. It's no forcing in Islam. You understand? You hear people say that Islam is spread by the sword. This is a big lie. You understand?
Yeah.
Okay, even let's assume that Islam is spread by the sword. Do you know how many Muslims in America converted in America? Okay. At least 8 to 10 million. We didn't have swords, we don't have guns here. People come like yourself, you understand, Jason, okay, that they come on their own and ask. People ask for books. People go and disappear for 2-3 years and read and think and think. And after this, they may be in another state and say, hey, I'm ready now. So we don't have anybody to put a gun in somebody's head or say, oh, the sword, you're going to be a Muslim or we're going. No. Islam itself is self-explanatory.
Yes.
And it's something, it talks to the mind and the heart. You can see it if you really want to see it. It's up to you. I give you a simple explanation to the best of my ability. If you think something fits with you, it's good. If you want to think more about it, it's good. If you want more information and books, it's good. Everything here, you going to run the show from here to whenever. Mm-hmm. Is your call. Mm-hmm. Is your call now. Okay. After I'm finished, you understand? This is your call. You decide what you want to do.
Okay.
So.
I can come back anytime.
Anytime, you understand? We open every day.
Okay.
And if you want more books, I give you more books.
Yes, sir.
And you can come with any question you want. You can even bring a minister or priest, anybody with you. We can sit and talk. We don't have to be fight. It's nothing to fight.
Yeah.
It's nothing to fight. Something good that God Almighty gave it all of us, that He gave each one of us His own mind so He can make His own thinking and His own decision. Because later on, you could not help me, I could not help you. God will ask you, I give you the mind for you to think. You decide to go by what's your parents. He decide to go by how he born. He decide. Those people who use their brain and their mind and their hearts and examine, those are the people who are going to be the winners. So you anytime you understand, you're welcome to think and to reflect and to ask a question. And we are not sitting here behind doors. No, we are open. You can bring a minister. He can come and question and tell me, oh, you don't know what you're talking about. And we can dialogue. We can debate. It's no problem. And after this, we're going to shake hands and leave friendly, everything. There's no need for fight. Fight of what? There's no need for fight.
Yeah.
So basically, you make the call. I'm here to assist, nothing else.
Okay.
So I leave it for you, okay? And you can make an appointment or you can come. If I'm available, I will sit with you, and we're going to give you at least one book more in details about the foundation. What do you think about it? Would you like to have another book with you to take it?
Is it okay if I convert and then get a book also?
Excuse me?
Is it okay if I convert and get a book also?
Oh, this is up to you. You I said it's your call.
Okay, I'm ready.
You sure?
Yes.
You want to convert? Convert to what?
Muslim.
You want to be a Muslim?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
Why you want to be a Muslim?
I really haven't had any faith in a long time on anything, really, besides there's being a God.
Okay.
And I've been thinking about it for a while now, and I read up on it for the past couple months. And in talking to you, you kind of helped me.
Okay. So you want to be a Muslim?
Yes.
And you agree with all what I said or most of what I said? Okay, main two things for the time being, if you want to be a Muslim, you're going to have to testify to the oneness of God, Almighty Allah, the Creator, and that you also you bear witness, okay, and confirm that Muhammad is the messenger and the last prophet of Almighty God.
Okay?
We will take steps little bit by little bit explaining the articles of belief and things like this. But if you testify, meaning it, not only saying it but your tongue, that you say with your tongue and you believe it in your heart, this will make you a Muslim. You want to do it?
Yes.
You sure now?
Yes.
Okay. You're going to say after me.
Okay.
And what you're going to be saying, the meaning of it, okay, I'm going to say the words and you're going to say it after me. But what you're going to say is, I testify that there is no deity worthy of worship other than Almighty Allah, and I testify that Muhammad is his messenger and the last of all the prophets.
Okay.
Do you believe this in your heart?
Yes.
And you're willing to make this statement?
Yes.
Okay. Say, Ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
Anna.
Anna.
La.
La.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illa.
Illa.
Allah.
Allah.
Wa.
Wa.
Ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
Anna.
Anna.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadan.
Rasulullah.
Rasulullah.
Allahu Akbar, congratulations. Happy for you. Happy for you. Justin.
Thank you.
Okay, sure. Man, this happy. I'm happy for you. This good. All right, all right.
I need more books.
Yes, yes, I'll give you more books. You can take all the boxes of books outside. Take whatever you want. I'm not going to give you. You go and take any book you want. Okay? Congratulations.
Thank you.
May God, Almighty Allah, our Creator, guide your heart and make you firm, make you strong. And now you already enter the house. You're in the house of Islam now, okay? And you need to, little bit by little bit, to learn, okay? We can assist you. You can ask questions. And you can visit at any time. Show him where is the boxes. Let him open any box he want. He take what he want.
Okay,
inshallah.
Anything I can do for you today?
You did everything, sir.
Thank you. Please, don't stay too long away from us, okay? Okay. Keep in touch.
I will.
All right.
I live all the way in Sumter, but he's close.
Okay, all right.
He's way out there. He lives an hour away.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar.
You want this chair back there, brother?
Excuse me?
You want this chair beside you?
No, that's okay. Doesn't matter. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're quite welcome. It's my duty. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah.
Thank you, brother Adly.
Brother.
Alhamdulillah,
this
brother.
Is a big
Thank
blessing.
You so much.
MashaAllah. Keep eye on him, huh? Keep in touch with him as much as you can. Even give him at least by call, okay? How are you today? How are things going? And things like
I pretty much talk to him every day.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. May Allah bless you. What's your name again?
Sajid.
Sajid, yes. Yes, brother. Sajid. You know, brother, I got old. I keep forgetting. All right, Sajid. Keep on him, huh? All right. Thank you. Yes.